Hello and welcome to lab. Today we're going to do experiment 8, heats of reaction. I'd like you to be my lab partner. Please follow along with the instructions in the lab manual. The first step in the procedure is to obtain some hydrochloric acid, which I've done, and normalize a 50 milliliter graduated cylinder. So I'll pour a little bit in and rinse all the inside surfaces with that hydrochloric acid, and that will go to the drain. Next, we'll set up our calorimeter setup. It's a double styrofoam calorimeter with a lid, and we are going to insert our 0 to 50 thermometer in the center, and we don't want it touching the bottom, but close, and we will use a thermometer clamp. And adjust that. Okay, that's pretty good. We can still shake it a little bit. Okay. Next, we'll make a note of the unknown number and the mass of the sample. This is going to be for part D. We have cubes of metal, and we'll be determining the specific heat of this metal. So we'll make a note of that, and we'll also fill a 400 milliliter beaker about two-thirds of the way with tap water, put it on our hot plate, and we will take some tongs and gently place the metal cube in the beaker. We'll turn on our hot plate and we'll get this boiling, and then we'll lay the 0 to 100, minus 20 to a little bit over 100 thermometer in the beaker on top of the metal. We'll move the metal to one of the sides and kind of lay it on the metal and the pour spout so it doesn't move around. Okay, we're done with our setup and we can start our procedure. In the first part of the procedure, we will be determining the heat of reaction between magnesium and hydrochloric acid. First, I'll obtain about 80 milliliters, and I'll have to do this in two additions, of hydrochloric acid. Now, it doesn't make any difference exactly how much hydrochloric acid you add. It just needs to be carefully measured. Now, these divisions are in 1 milliliter, so you'll need to estimate to the 1/10 of a milliliter, or 0.1. Okay, now that we've done that, that's our first addition, we'll pour it in our calorimeter setup. And I'll pour in another about 40. We just need our total volume to be approximately 80 mils. Okay, I'd like you to read this one. All right, now I'll add our second addition. Of hydrochloric acid to our calorimeter setup. And I'll just put the lid on, and we're just going to let that temperature stabilize. in step three, I've obtained about 9 to 10 inches of magnesium ribbon. And you'll see that there's some magnesium oxide, the black line kind of down the center, that has been on here. We are going to use some sandpaper and get most of that off. It's not critical that you remove all of it, but a good amount of removal is necessary. We want to measure only the magnesium. Now that I've removed most of my magnesium oxide, I'm just going to wipe this ribbon with a paper towel. I'm going to kind of fold it into a little bundle. And then can you please weigh this and accurately record it in the data sheet? Now that the hydrochloric acid in your calorimeter, the temperature has stabilized, I'd like you to read it now. In step five of the procedure, I'm going to lift the lid of my calorimeter setup quickly and then insert the magnesium bundle that we've weighed. Then I'll shake the setup a little bit and we'll read the final temperature. Okay. I'm just shaking so everything gets mixed. I see my temperature rising. I actually heard a reaction, and I think it's almost all over. And let's read this final temperature. In the next part, we are going to perform the neutralization of hydrochloric acid with sodium hydroxide and measure that enthalpy. We need to have a clean and dry calorimeter, so I have done that. I've wiped out the inside quite well with a paper towel. We are going to be adding also about 80 milliliters of the hydrochloric acid measured in two portions and put it in the calorimeter cup. I'd like you to read both of these. Now that I've added my hydrochloric acid to the calorimeter, I'll reassemble the calorimeter, putting the lid on and making sure that the thermometer is close to the bottom but does not touch the bottom of the calorimeter setup. We're going to wait a little while for this to stabilize, but in the meantime, I've obtained some sodium hydroxide in a beaker, and I've added about 20 milliliters to the graduated cylinder, and I'd like you to read that. Now that the reading has stabilized the thermometer, I'd like you to read the temperature of the hydrochloric acid. in step four of this procedure, we're going to quickly add the sodium hydroxide that we measured and add it to our calorimeter setup. I'm going to again shake as before and read the maximum temperature. Okay, this is an exothermic reaction, so our temperature is increasing. And again, we're determining the delta H of hydrochloric acid and sodium hydroxide. And I think the temperature has reached its maximum level. So let's read that. In part C, we are going to determine the heat of neutralization of the solution of ammonium nitrate. First, we will need to rinse out and dry our calorimeter cup, and I've already done that. And then we're going to measure about 80 milliliters of DI water. And I've already normalized this graduated cylinder with DI water. And we'll do this in two additions as before. And after you've added about 80, carefully recorded, 80 milliliters to the calorimeter setup, I'd like you to measure and record about 1.5 grams of ammonium nitrate and record that in your data sheet. Now that the temperature of our DI water has stabilized, I'd like you to read it. Now I'm going to quickly lift the lid of my calorimeter setup and add my ammonium nitrate to it. Close the lid and then I'll shake and swirl gently. Okay, this is an endothermic reaction, so our temperature should go down. This is the same reaction that are in ice packs on the sports field. And our temperature's dropping nicely. Let's read this final temperature. In our next step, we'll determine the specific heat of our unknown metal. We needed to dry out the calorimeter cup, and I've already done that. Next, I need 150 milliliters, about that, but carefully measured in three portions of DI water from a graduated cylinder. I'd like you to do those measurements. Now that we've added about 150 milliliters of DI water to our calorimeter setup, and we've allowed the temperature of the water to stabilize, I'd like you to read the temperature. I'd also like you to read and record the temperature of the metal. And we're just going to assume that since the metal has been in this boiling water for quite some time, that the temperature of the water, that's what the thermometer is reading, will be the temperature of the metal. In the next step, we are going to take the metal cube out of the boiling water, give it a little shake to remove any excess water, and then we're going to put it in our calorimeter setup. Very gently. And we will read the maximum temperature of the water. Still going up. Give it a little bit of a shake to make sure all of the water gets to the same temperature. And it looks like our temperature has leveled off. I'd like you to read this. Now we're done with the experiment. We can clean up. We'll dump all of our solutions to the drain. We'll completely dry the metal cube and return it to its container. And then kind of place all of our equipment in the center, ready for the next group. And we'll also dry out our calorimeter cup. Thanks for being my lab partner today.